salary. Baby gon' touch the bucks, my salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle and the pick and I hustle. I had to have it, had to get in the huddle, in the gravel and rubble. Got me a second, I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking, better stand back and watch him run. Shotgun, come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Thought I heard somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the locker. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Animosity was out inside of me, so I'm like a product of Broadway.
Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Okay. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
This Lion fan base have been craving home playoff football since this building opened in 2002, and they've got it today at Ford Field in Detroit. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Seattle Seahawks and the Detroit Lions. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Here's Wilson to throw. That's complete. It's Carson out of the backfield. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Wilson after the play fake to Carson. He's got Gronkowski yet again. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried the dump off, lost yardage. Wilson will throw again. Goes right side, complete to Gronk. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, just keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. Now it's Carson. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. From midfield now, here's Wilson. Incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Rolling to his right. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And this crowd into it early. Their guys stand tall on the opening drive of the football game. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and 6.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Runs over him. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. But one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On second down, Holiday. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. So that run gets them about halfway home.
Yeah, it's now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play action and try and put it in that way.
On second down now, Holiday. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. Stopped short of the goal line. A gain of 3 yards. It's now third and goal. We're scoreless after 1. No score. second quarter action now from Detroit, and it's the homestanding Lions who have the football, as they'll see what they can do on third and goal. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1 yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. Now the Lions, they send out the field goal unit here. Less than an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. Blankenship's kick is good. And the Lions are going to take a 3-0 lead. So our initial drive of the night ends in 3 points. Maybe not exactly what this home crowd wanted, but they'll take the early lead.
They will take it. You're exactly right. Everybody wants a touchdown. But in this case, good opening drive, put points on the board. And a lot of coaches do believe the first team to score in the game, statistically, often ends up the winner.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Sliding out of the pocket. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40 before being taken down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
On first down, it's Carson, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Play action. It's Wilson. Escaping the play. The ball comes out. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. Can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Play action. Now Wilson. Out to his left. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Good job starting on that scramble. Had his eyes on that first down marker, CD, but lost the most important thing, the football.
Yeah, wasn't quite there. Focused solely on getting to the first down marker. Forgot to cover up and take care of the ball.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. The previous run, good for nine. Here's second and a yard. No. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 47 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
Brings up second and 7 at the 43-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And that's out to the flat for Swift. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30.
Well, I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
Finding room to the 20. And all the way down to the 17-yard line. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They give him 4 yards there, it'll be second and 6.
It's now second and 6.
They run the counter. Holiday. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Now, after that last running play, we've got an offensive lineman down on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. To throw. Curran. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Jordan Brooks with it. And he will bring this across midfield to the 49-yard line. That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level that quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback. He expected something different from his receiver, whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter. They'll determine that on the sideline. The bottom line, you could see that he thought he'd be in a different spot, except the defender was not his intended target.
Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Gary and Conley. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
They'll run on first down. Holiday. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And they'll get to him just inside the 15. Even after the strong run we just saw, they're able to corral him quickly defensively. After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down.
And a give this time to the tailback. And he is going to have a Lions first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Looking to throw. Curran. Looking for Hockenson, and he's got him. Touchdown, Detroit. T.J. Hockenson, as the first half is winding down. And the Lions will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And the lead grows to 10-0. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And we'll see what they want to do, just 20 seconds remaining here before the half. He'll buy some time right. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete. So he was past the line of scrimmage when he threw it.
And as they say, that's a no-no. Got to be able to understand where you are on the field and not cross the line before throwing the ball downfield.
They go play action now. Wilson. Going to air it out deep for Gronkowski. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Gronk, so tough to cover. Sometimes the flag's going to come out.
His size and his ability create a lot of these pass interference calls. If you're trying to go through him to get to the ball, that's almost impossible. And he benefits on the play.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They go play action with Wilson. They'll roll him out right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. The kick by McManus is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. A trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Jakeem Grant now to return. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But if they run it more effectively, they may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
Second and 5. They'll keep it on the ground. Holiday. 97 yards rushing for him now on 17 carries. He had a really solid first half running the football and picking up where he left off here in the third quarter.
How about the yardage he's piling up right now? This feels like a full game, not just this series that we're watching right now. I know people are screaming, where are the adjustments from halftime on the defensive side of the ball? Sometimes they're just not there. Sometimes you just have to find a way to tackle someone.
On first down, Holiday. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
On second down, Holiday. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Play action, Curran. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Bobby Wagner, multiple times an All-Pro, in there to drop him for a loss.
That'd be exactly what they were looking for coming out to start the third quarter. Get a sack, get off the field, get the momentum going in their direction.
Get the ball back to your offense, right? Get that momentum because, hey, this lead is very, very slim. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. It's a 45-yard punt and 8 on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football, 1st and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in gear? Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. This defense, Charles, coming up with another interception. They have really done an excellent job of locking up these receivers.
Yeah, they're really on fire. They are actually doing what they talk about all the time, which is plastering to receivers when they're in their zones. They didn't give up a touchdown in the first half. Haven't done so here in this half either. Blanketed the field, going all the way back to the opening drive, and they come up with a pick right there.
They'll run on first down. Holiday. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run and the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
A give, Jefferson to the right side.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
So not quite a first and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. Here's a handoff to Swift. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Right back to Swift again on second down. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
on third down. Holiday. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This a fairly straightforward 22-yard short attempt. Blankenship's kick is good. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So the lead extended. I think at this point you say, hey, defense, take us to the end.
Well, if I got some good music to put to that, I could have a good country hit. I like the way you express yourself there. I think the offense has done enough so far. But like you say, if your defense is only giving up 3 points, it makes it a lot easier to settle for field goals on this side of the ball.
Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Now a throw here, hauled in. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now Wilson dumps this one off to Chris Carson. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. The play fake. Here's Wilson rolling to his right. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I think he learned from earlier in the game, and he's applying it now.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Now it's Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And the Lions force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
A throw left side to start the drive is complete, and they're able to get this one across the 35.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, They almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Off the play fake, Curran. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
Looking to throw on second down. Curran flushed out right. Throwing right, and that's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
On first down, Swift, and he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces, and I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
He's going to fire one deep left sideline. Two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a two-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on it and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing them.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that is incomplete.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit him over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Wilson. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 23. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line. So the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard.
He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Now this throw caught left side.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you...
And I think the ball's out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Offensively, they're just not playing a very clean football game right now. This deficit, there's a fumble. Good news for them, at least, that went out of bounds.
You're exactly right, and as they breathe a sigh of relief, you know they're looking at the scoreboard, thinking to themselves, if we turn it over there, things could really get rough for us trying to make a comeback in this game.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Fabian Moreau. And the Lions are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
2nd and 9.
Off play action. Curran. He'll rifle this one deep right side. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Detroit. A big play there. 56 yards. And the Lions are moving closer to a date now in the NFC Championship game as they're able to extend this fourth quarter lead.
Rodrigo Blankenship on for the PAT.
And the lead is now 24.
So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a good chance to pin them deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
Taking it about the 1. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15.
Now I think we're going to get a timeout here. Yes, a timeout here as it looks like we've got a Lion that's shaken up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 16. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
Throw right side, taken in by Eskridge.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Now Wilson on 1st down.
A quick target here, complete to Metcalf.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They're looking at 2nd down now as they search for a consolation score. On 2nd and inches, Wilson. Room to run past midfield. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. Well, throw on 1st down with Wilson.
Here's Carson with a catch out of the backfield.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
Throwing again here, Wilson.
And this will go to Carson out wide.
And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. Throwing is Wilson. And now here's another interception. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So many times we end a game, and as we're recapping it, we're talking about what offenses did and how they won the game. Let's flip this one over. The defense, they frustrated the offense the entire ball game. That's why they're walking out of here with a victory.
And they're going to love to walk out of here with that as their final act, that interception. Good way for them to end it. They'll run on first down. Holiday, and he'll take this one up to about the 13. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. Working with second and five now. They'll keep it on the ground. Holiday, and he'll get it up here this time to the 21. 120 yards rushing for him now in the ball game as he is trying to will his guys to the championship round next weekend. First down, Holiday, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Now we'll get whistles, and they signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. 6 yards left on second down. They run the counter. Holiday. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Oh, wait, hold everything. A timeout has been called. Seemingly silly with 1 second remaining in this game. The play fake. Curran. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by Casey Hayward. And they can't bring him down. And the Seahawks come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. The Lions stay alive as we say thanks for watching and so long.